فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today's benefit is going to be the ayah in Surah Al-Qiyamah, ayah 14 to ayah 15, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةٌ وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, rather the human being, he is one who has insight of himself. He has very well knowledge of himself. وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَةٌ, even if he puts forward excuses. The person is one who knows himself very well. He knows himself. And even if he tries to bring excuses forward, the truth and the reality is, you know yourself. This ayah, or these two verses, they teach us how to deal with ourselves and how to cure our problems that we may have. And it is also a stepping stone, a ladder of how to purify your soul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Shams, 11 places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he makes an oath. He swears, 11 verses. And from of those is the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Verily, prosperity is for the one who purifies his soul, he purifies his heart, he purifies himself. So this ayah that we're taking today, which is بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةٌ وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَةٌ, is, it's a sulam, it's a ladder to getting to purify your nafs. And it is, you as an individual, you know what you're saying, you know what you're doing, and you know exactly your intent behind everything you say and you do. Even if you try to put forward excuses, explanations, there's no proof against you greater than yourself. And it's amazing because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةٌ. Allah used the word basira. He used that word, دُونَ غَيْرِهَا مِنَ الْأَلْفَاظِ, without using any other term, without using any other word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically chose to use the word basira. Because basira, what is in it, or in the meaning of basira, is al-wuduh wal-hujjah. That this thing is clear-cut proof. There is no darkness or taint on it. It is clear-cut proof. It's like somebody saying to you, anta hujjah ala nafsik, you are a proof against yourself. And that's why you find in the kitab al-tahrir wa-tanweer by Ibn Ashur, that he says, وَقَدْ جَرَتْ هَذِهِ الْجُمْلَةِ, this sentence, or this verse, it has taken the path, مَجْرَ الْمَثَلِ, it became a parable, it became a proverb, لِإِجَازِهَا وَفْرَةِ مَعَانِيهَا, because of how summarized it is, and how strong and powerful the meaning that is in it is. This ayah, brothers, it falls in مجالات كثيرة في واقعنا. It falls in our life. You can apply this verse if truly it is pondered on and it's understood properly. It can be put into many situations of our life, whether it's general matters or specific matters. Some of them, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention, so we can benefit from it and perfect our situation and our dealings. Number one, This ayah can be used for those people who, when they deal with the textual evidences, Nusus al-Wahyayn, al-Kitab wa-Sunnah, and they know that the evidences have been established on them, the proof has been brought to them, the clear-cut proof, in which the scholars have not differed. The scholars, they have not differed in what? Fi dalalatihi, what this meaning of this verse means. Somebody comes up to you, and he brings you an ayah, and he says to you, Akhi, look at the verse. And this, look what you're doing. And this is the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The scholars, they have not differed on what this verse means. And what you're doing falls under this verse, the prohibition here. And you're still doing it. You find a lot of people, instead of accepting it, he throws forward those excuses. He tries to deflect the text. Why? لِأَنَّهُ لَمْ يُوَافِقْ هَوَاهُ, because it's not in accordance to his whims and desires. If you go to the Kitab Risalah by Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, his Kitab At-Tabukiyyah, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, which is also known as the Zadul al-Muhajir, it's called the Zadul al-Muhajir. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions this point regarding this ayah. And Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he has a statement in his Kitab Sayyid al-Khatir that one can find benefit from it in regards to that particular verse being used in the majal, the one who wants to deflect the evidence. Also, this verse can be applied on those who follow the mistakes of people. They sit down to get people's mistakes. بِتَتَبْعِ أَخْطَاءِ النَّاسِ وَعُيُوبِهِمْ. He sits down just to find people's shortcomings and their mistakes. Whilst مَعَ غَفْلَةِ عَنْ عُيُوبِ نَفْسِهِ. Whilst he is heedless of his own mistakes and his own shortcomings. And that is one of the explanation that Qatadat ibn Da'amat al-Sadusi rahimahullah, he put regarding this ayah, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. He said, rahimahullah, that if you want, wallahi by Allah, he's saying, rahimahullah, if you wish, إِذَا شِئْتَ وَاللَّهِ رَأَيْتَ بَصِيرًا بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ وَذُنُوبِهِمْ. You will see that he has insight of the people's shortcomings and their mistakes. غَافِلًا عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِ. But he is heedless of his own ones. And that, my brothers, is what? This is wallahi a bala'un, it is a problem, and it is min alamatul khidlan, and it's from the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is destroying you. And that is exactly what Bakr ibn Abdullah al-Muzani rahimahullah said. He said, idha ra'aytum, if you guys see a man muwakkilan bi'uyub al-nas, who stands up to get the people's mistakes, nasiyan li'uyubihi, but he is forgetful of his own mistakes, فَعْلَمُوا نَوْ أَنَّهُ قَدْ مُكِّرَ بِهِ, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has, or that he has been deceived. Know that that individual has been deceived. So, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرًا. You know yourself very well. Even if you give as much excuses as you will. Also, this can be applied for those people, my brothers, who debate for themselves, they argue for themselves in places which their mistakes have become clear to them. الَّتِي تَبَيَّنَ فِيهَا خَطَأُ. His mistake is clear to him. He knows what he said, did is wrong. And he's convinced that what he's doing and what he's saying or what he was doing was wrong. And Ibn Taymiyyah, he brought it regarding that meaning, rahimahullah, he said, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةً وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرًا فَإِنَّهُ يَعْتَذِرُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ بِأَعْذَارٍ. He will give excuses for himself, excuses, وَيُجَادِلُ عَنْهَا, and he argues for himself. وَهُوَ يُبْصِرُهَا بِخِلَافِ ذَلِكَ. Even though he sees himself to be opposite to what he's arguing for. So my brothers, Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, the great scholar Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, he said, كَانَتْ فِي عُيُوب. I used to have mistakes. And he said, I never remained except exercising and I'm trying to look for the mistakes that are in me, how I could work on them. Because my brothers, one knowing and acknowledging himself to be short in a matter and adhering to the commands of Allah by saying I'm wrong. Because knowing yourself is something which the ayah is referring to as Nabiullah Ayyub alayhi salam. And you see this all in the prophets. This is the maqam of the anbiya and the salihin and the siddiqeen. It is the path of the truthful ones, the righteous ones, the prophets. Look, for example, you see Nabiullah and Nabiullah Adam alayhi salam, our father. What did he say? Him and Hawa, what did they both say when they ate from the tree? حين أكل من الشجرة, what did they say? قَالَا رَبَّنَا, our Lord, ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا, we have transgressed on ourselves. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, and if you don't forgive us, وَتَرْحَمْنَا, and you don't have mercy upon us, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, we're going to be from the destroyed ones. Nuh alayhi salam, what did he say? This is when Allah prohibited him from asking that which he had no knowledge for. This is after he made, you know, he wanted his son to be saved. And he spoke and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited him from asking something he has no knowledge for. Look what he did straight away. He admits, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ, oh Allah, I seek refuge in you. أَنْ أَسْأَلَكَ, for me to ask, مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِهِ عِلْمٌ, that which I have no knowledge of. وَإِلَّا تَغْفِرْ لِي, and if you do not have, if you don't forgive me, وَتَرْحَمْنِي, and if you don't have mercy upon me, أَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, أَكُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, I'm going to be from the destroyed ones. You find Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam. Nabiullah Musa, نَدِمًا عَلَى قَتْلِهِ الْقُبْطِي, when he killed the Qibti. Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, when he punched the Qibti, and he killed him and he died. What did he do? رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي فَغْفِرْ لِي فَغَفَرَ لَهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. All of them are saying, oh Allah, oh my Lord, I have transgressed. My soul has transgressed. Forgive me. And then Allah forgive them. So all of them you find, they affirm and they acknowledge their shortcomings. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said, when he brought the ayah, وَآخَرُونَ اعْتَرَفُوا بِذُنُوبِهِمْ خَلَطُوا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَآخَرَ سَيِّئًا عَسَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he spoke about that verse about some people who وَآخَرُونَ اعْتَرَفُوا بِذُنُوبِهِمْ, some of them, they acknowledge their mistakes. You see, they mix their mistakes with righteous actions, and some of them, they came with sins. They all acknowledged, asked Allah for forgiveness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was one that forgave them. Ibn Taymiyyah said, for ulima, it was known, just by that verse told us, أَنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يَعْتَرِفْ بِذَنْبِهِ, the one who does not recognize his mistakes, كَانَ مِنَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ, he's from the hypocrites. Because the ayah affirms that the munafiqeen were not ones who acknowledged their mistakes. The believers are the ones who came back to Allah and they asked for forgiveness. But the munafiqeen, they didn't. And so we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to make us from those who acknowledge their mistakes and that which their soul really is and knows their position. Not to pretend what you're not and to act like what you're not, but to be one who knows himself. The fa'idah was regarding the ayah, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرَةٌ وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرَةٌ. We conclude there for this today, inshaAllah ta'ala's benefit. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.